The award-winning Black Isle Studios, in association with Reflexive Entertainment, bring you the next great role-playing game. Lionheart, Legacy of the Crusader. Part history and part fantasy, Lionheart's gripping action and lush graphics deliver an epic story of an alternate medieval Earth. As a character in a world ravaged by magical catastrophe, you will need to gain allies, power, and understand your own heritage in order to save humankind. And now, we take you behind the scenes to hear directly from the creators of the game. Welcome to Lionheart, Legacy of the Crusader, the making of the game.
I think the thing that makes Lionheart so special is that it both has the depth of an RPG and also the adventure of an action game. We've worked really, really hard to make sure that we've preserved all the things that players expect to see in an RPG from Black Isle. And we've also worked very hard to make sure that the game is engaging and has a lot of good action elements.
One of the things we're most proud of in Lionheart is the story. Current game time is 1588. 400 years previous to that, there was a disjunction that let loose magic and evil spirits into the world. And the current game time has really been at the effect of that. Part of France has slid into the ocean. Spanish Armada is going to battle against England, but for different reasons than they did in history. And different historical characters have different motives for what they're doing, why they're doing what they're doing. Da Vinci is there, Galileo is there. There's lots of historical characters that are there, but they're doing things differently. They're reacting in different ways. And you're basically going to get to interact and do different quests with these characters.
When you make your character in Lionheart, you're able to choose from four different races. The main pureblood human race, and three divergent races that have sprung up because of the introduction of magic onto Earth. And those races are the Feralkin, the Demakin, and the Silvent. And basically each of these provide a little bit different gameplay element for the player that selects them. The Feralkin is sort of the hulking brute, the Silvent is the magically oriented character, and then the Demakin is a very agile and quick race. One of the things that I really enjoy about Lionheart is the classless role-playing system, which is called Special. And you're not bound into any sort of class like a warrior or a mage. You advance by spending points into different skills. And so what that means is that you can advance your character any way you want. If you want to be really good at combat or really good at magic or really good at speech, those are decisions that you make for your character. And you can change later on. Halfway through the game, you decide you want to be better at speech, start spending skill points there. When you play Lionheart single player, you make one character, and then there are other characters within the game world that can join with your one character as you adventure through the story. And one of the cool things that we've introduced is a cooperative multiplayer mode where you and three of your buddies can each make their own character, join into the same game, and then play through the game together as a party.
Lionheart has a massive opportunity for replayability. Depending on which faction you choose, your gameplay experience will vary, and the way the characters and monsters will respond to you drastically differ depending on which faction you choose. So you could always go through and play the game again with an entirely different faction and come across an entirely new story.